In this video, I will be showing you how to create this modern square-shaped ceiling lamp that utilizes 9 GU10 LED spots for traditional illumination purposes, but additionally features an RGBW LED strip, which is used for indirect mood lighting. The color of it can of course get adjusted by regular RF remotes, but also through a Wi-Fi control app, which is certainly handy to have. So sit back and enjoy the rather lengthy and exhausting process of creating this ceiling lamp by me and my assistant in around 5 days of work. Let's get started! This video is sponsored by JLC PCB, where you can get 10 PCBs for the price of only $2. So feel free to upload your Gerber files today to test out their PCB service. Now before I can show you all the super fun mechanical and electrical work we had to go through, I need to firstly present you the blueprint of the ceiling lamp we had in mind. Basically put, we wanted to create a big cuboid, which features 9 LED spots at the bottom and houses a long LED strip on the top. Sounds easy, but the details are where it got complicated. To create the depth of the cuboid, we used stacked up wood laths with dimensions of 24 by 48 mm. For the bottom part, we used barrel board rapids, which is a so-called Leichtbauplatte, meaning it is light but can handle quite a bit of force. Sadly though, it only came with dimensions of 1200 by 800 mm. So we had to get creative to achieve our designated dimension of 1.2 by 1.2 meters, but more about that later. For the upper parts, we used a 90 mm thick piece of MDF, which was quite heavy but necessary, because we wanted to house the RGBW LEDs inside this MDF piece, flat with its surface. Now I could bore you even more with what lengths all of our screws got, or more detailed information on how we achieve proper load balancing, or what kind of components are necessary for the electrical wiring. But for now you should get the basic idea of the lamp, so let's get started building. We started off by opening up our wood lath pack, onto which we then created precisely measured markings to build two wood squares. For that, we firstly used the jigsaw to create the 8 required wood lath pieces, and then formed a square with the first 4 of them. By using those brackets and a 2.5 mm drill, we firstly pre-drilled holes and then used wood screws to join all the wood laths together. As soon as the first square was done, it was time to repeat the bracket mounting process in order to form the second square. Before joining them though, I added a bigger wood screw for stability through all edge connections. Afterwards, we stacked up the two squares and combined them by using 16 longer screws. At this point, we brought in the first barrel board rapids, which, as you can imagine, we secured to the wood square with tons of screws, after marking evenly spaced locations for them. Then we positioned the second board, marked where we need to cut it, and used a jigsaw for that, which worked surprisingly well. After adding mounting adhesive, we pushed the boards together and secured the second one with screws as well. To properly space the LED spots, we created a 4x4 checkerboard onto the now acquired complete bottom board and used a 68mm Auskreiser, for which I could not find a proper English translation, in order to create the holes for the metal housing of the GU10 LED spots. After all 9 holes were created, we measured out and cut 2 more wood laths, which we positioned inside the square and secured them to it to improve its stability. Once the barrel board rapids was mounted to those wood pieces as well, it was time for the electrical wiring work, which required quite a bit of material. The process was simple though, I firstly pushed the GU10 socket wires into a small distribution box, added VAGO terminals to them, pushed NIM wire into the same box, added the live and neutral wire to one VAGO terminal each, and closed the box up. While this work looks simple, it is important to note though that it should be done by a professional electrician. You have been warned. But anyway, once all 9 boxes were wired up, I added 11 holes to a bigger terminal box, which I then mounted to one inner wood lathe. After then pushing all 9 smaller terminal box wires into the bigger one, I used VAGO terminals once again to connect all neutral and live wires in parallel. At the end of this wiring process, I removed the socket of the LED power supply cable, removed the insulation of its wires, and added those to the VAGO terminals, along with an additional NIM hookup wire, which I prepared beforehand. As soon as all the wiring was complete, I closed up the terminal box and finally moved on to the big MDF board, for which I firstly needed another box though, which contained aluminum profiles with a milky white acrylic top for the LED strips. Those featured a height of 8mm and a width of 14mm, which were important dimensions for the groove cutter I chose. By adding it to a hand router, I was able to create a very precise indentation, which can take in the aluminum profile and thus create a flush surface. Very neat. So I marked a half complete square onto the MDF piece edges, drilled a hole for the starting point of the router, and then used it to create the 4 indentation lines, which together formed a square. Next, I marked a suitable length for the profiles and cut them with a simple handsaw. Afterwards, we utilized mounting adhesive to secure them inside the indentations. At this point, I unpacked the RGBW LED kit with all of its components, which I got for cheap from eBay. After hooking it all up, I tested whether the remote worked, which it did, and afterwards tested the Wi-Fi control app, which worked beautifully as well. So I created a hole next to the start LED strip, through which I will later feed the wires, and continued by removing the acrylic glass top, measuring out the LED strips, cutting them, and securing them inside the profiles with the adhesive backs. At the end, I had to connect all 4 individual strips through 0.75mm wire, otherwise the following LED light-up test would not have been successful. But since one test was not enough, I also tested the complete electrical system, which as you can see worked without a problem. Before joining the MDF board to the lamp though, we created 4 more wood lathe pieces, which we once again used to increase the stability of the structure. Once that was done, I drilled a big hole in the middle of the MDF board, hooked up the LED power supply to the LEDs, and finally positioned the MDF boards onto the lamp. Needless to say, we pre-drilled a ton of holes and used big wood screws to properly secure the MDF board, before we moved the whole lamp over to a higher position. Here we created a simple yet complicated mounting mechanic for the lamp, which required a lot of measuring, cutting, drilling, mounting, and a lot of other interesting woodworking terms. But let me break it down for you on paper, so you understand how it works. We basically secure a piece of wood onto the ceiling, which features 4 pieces of wood which have a big hole in the center. Through this hole, we can push this massive M14 threaded rod. Now the lamp got a fitting wood construction with 4 pieces of wood as well, which we can use to interlock the lamp with the ceiling structure, through the M14 rod. Easy! So as soon as the systems worked together successfully, we mounted the ceiling part of it, but not the lamp yet. Because beforehand we added veroboard rapids all around the wood square, added a bit of putty around the edges, sanded it down, and glued ingrained wallpaper on the lamp to make it look good. Once that was done, we lifted the lamp up, did the mains voltage wiring and secured it to the ceiling. After then inserting all the GU10 LEDs, the lamp was finally complete. Now I'm very happy with the results, and I hope it inspires you to build something similar on your own. If you liked this video, then don't forget to like, share and subscribe. Stay creative, and I will see you next time!